Good morning. It's Thursday, the 25th of May, and Alistair and I are going for an adventure ride. We are going up to Tape and Tops National Park, Dingo Tops National Park, Oxley Wild Rivers, and another one that I just probably can't remember. It's just going to be another video of me not knowing absolutely anything. Anyway, I've packed the bike. I've managed to get all my pubbing gear on. The issue we have with the ride this time is we have booked into pubs, but we're in such a remote area and there's just two of us that we've decided to take all our camping gear as well, just in case we get stuck because we haven't done this ride before. This is a ride that doesn't get done very often, I don't think, but we could get stuck with fallen trees, creeks, flooding, snake bites, the works. So anyway, I've packed to stay at a pub and I've packed to go camping. So there's quite a lot of gear on the bike. So, but I finished and I managed to get everything on and maybe I could fit a couple of toothpicks in if I wanted to. So as I'm twisting around, I don't know whether this will work. So anyway, here is the bike. This chockers. So we've got tent, I've got a chair, I've got the world's biggest chair. Probably chairs overkill. Tent poles, all my pubbing gear, all my camping gear, and all the towing gear, towing straps, pulley, rope, bit of food in that one, water, a little bit of food in that one, and gloves, extra, and wet weather gear in that one. So it's packed quite tightly. I don't want to lose anything. It doesn't look very good. And just a little tank bag. I'm sort of ready to go, I hope. I'm just going to take it for a little test run and see how it goes. Try not to crash.
So Alistair's over here. He just popped in and we are going over some of the stuff that we need to do, and we've just connected our helmets up again. So could you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. Yeah, you're good.
You're happy with
Audi,
the
$100.
Is that the same as Jacob's?
Don't know.
He said that you've got a slightly better one.
I know Audi's selling two or three different sets. So I'm quite happy with it.
So we're just checking out the gear, make sure we haven't forgotten anything. Alistair's just had a test ride and he's realised that he's still cold because he always whinges about being cold.
Well, I'm not as fat as some people, you know, so I'm fine, so, you know.
I was thinking ahead. 35 years ago.
Yeah.
So, we're just checking the bikes out and we'll go down and have a look at the bikes now.
So just going down to check the bikes out. Alice is going home now. We've talked about our creek crossings.
Go home, put my line in.
We're just going to die. It's rained today, rained heavily here, but it hasn't rained too much up there at all, and we've got to do at least 15 creek crossings. And there's Alice's bike. So you're a bit cold coming over?
Definitely cold, yeah. Now we're going north, mate, towards the summer.
Yep, of course. Takes some time to get all your shit on, doesn't it?
Yes. You bring us another pair of gloves?
I got 3 pairs of gloves.
Yeah.
The gloves I got on. My gauntlets, just in case it's really, really, really fucking cold. Oh, that's right, I'm not going to swear in this video too much. I've failed at that already. So. All right, I'll see you tomorrow at 7 o'clock, man.
All right, I'll go practice.
Yeah. Be safe. Yeah. Ring me if you need anything.
Yeah,
see you, bud. Oh, nearly come off. Oh, nearly come off again. So we will now meet each other at the service station at Morisset at 7 o'clock tomorrow. It will be cold. Hopefully he doesn't come off now as he goes up the hill. Hopefully. Is he still on? Yeah, he looks okay. Oh, giving it to it. And he's gone.
trying to get all this gear on is hard work. But I'm done. Everything's right. Just adjust this one. Okay. Well, that's a bit difficult. That's a bit difficult. Wow, get my leg over that. Got the linings in on my jacket and pants, and it just makes that a little bit tighter. Okay, we're off. Meet Alistair. Don't crash in the first 30 seconds. It's a bit lumpy, this bit. The lid down, and we're off. Most important thing to remember this weekend, take it out of street mode. Then you have brakes. It's in the street. And everything's okay. Cool. We're off. Yeah. Watch the kangaroos. Just really get careful of. By the time 6:36. Perfect timing. Okay, we're heading into the mountains today, and tomorrow is going to be -4, -5 at Barrington Tops. So we might get temperatures very close to that. Where we're going, we shall see. Oh, cows! Look, white one. Very nice. 6:49. I'm 10 minutes early. Alistair is normally early. So let's see if I beat him. It's not a race. trade, he's getting poise. Oh, I've beaten him. Wow. Something smells good around here. Good news, didn't crash in the first 10 minutes. That's always a plus. 6 degrees now, was 5. There he is. The mighty Suzuki DR400. And he's packed to the rafters. Bit of weight. Oh, he's redesigned. That was different yesterday. Yep, how are you? Oh, look at him, he's rugged up.
Couple hours already.
How are you, bud?
Yeah, I'm alright.
Good.
Been up for hours.
Yeah, so have I. 1:30.
Did I tell you last night my lights went down?
Yes.
Yeah?
Yes.
Half my house is working, so today I was fucking getting dressed under Torx light and stuff like that.
Okay, well, it's good that you're leaving then.
Yeah, it's frustrating.
Yeah.
Anyway, yeah. Alright.
We're ready?
I'm ready.
Let's see if we can get these helmets working. All right, Alistair and I now are on the freeway. He's behind me. And it is 6 degrees. We're doing just under 100 kilometers an hour. And we're just about to get into some sun, which will be really nice because it is quite cool doing 100. There it is there. There's the sun. Excellent. Hopefully it'll warm up soon. On our way to Gloucester. And we are at the Hexham Bridge. And it's 9 degrees, warming up slowly. Alistair's behind me and we've lost intercoms for whatever reason. Fuck its way. Alistair's in front, I'll catch up to him. Unfortunately, our intercoms are intermittent today. So I just turned my headset off. 10, 11 degrees, starting to warm up a little bit. Was cold this morning coming up the freeway. Cruisy 82 kilometers an hour. I don't know where we are. Want to look at the map. Boral. We're at Boral. Got a GPS in front of me. Why don't I just look at that? It is. That's right. Very, very nice. Don't stand on me. Knees and legs are a bit sore from paving yesterday. Been there quite a few times. Beer's cold. Some nice old houses here. Just gone through Washpool. It's a nice view. It's a bit cold when you stand up. Wow! Ooh, look at house! Still only 12 degrees. Could be a bit warmer. I didn't feel this cold when I was down at Hill Inn a couple of weeks ago. It's crazy. Beautiful morning. We're now coming into Gloucester. I think this is the golf course. Well, no, it's the golf course. It is 12 degrees still, 9:26. Nice set of hills. So we've just turned off the Buckets Way. We just had breakfast at Gloucester. And Alistair's got a bit of speed. He's feeling very confident. Alright, but it'll be interesting now if your voice comes up, because I can hear you very clearly. Look at that house to the left there, Alistair. Yeah, the little red tree in the front, two of them. Very nice. Yeah, oh yeah. Yeah, try and stay in the road, Alistair. Yeah, I just had to turn my my heated grips down. Oh, that's right, you don't have heated grips, that's a shame. Well, the man seems to be doing a lot of whinging in the front there, if it's a man's bike. So this is, this, Yeah, it's good. It's all good. This is Boondock Road. So, you know, you in front gives us a bit of content for the video. Yeah, right, okay. Yeah, okay. That's right, it's a man's bike. It doesn't have a temperature gauge. Well, it's just more shit to break down, isn't it, really? And made sure I turned it into off-road mode, so I actually have some brakes. It's very important. Very important to have brakes. Again, just beautiful countryside. Yep. Oh, and more cows. I love cows. I like eating them. There you go. Anything with four legs, mate. Okay, was there a turn back there, bud? Okay, just stop for a sec. Just stop. Let me just catch up to you and let me just check my GPS. I was standing up and I wasn't watching it. Yeah. Well, you haven't got the route in there. Yeah, it's telling us to turn around. Yeah. That is a better idea, isn't it? Much better. Okay. It'll be to the right now. Yeah, okay. We'll get there in a second. Well, you don't have the route anyway, mate, so it's not your fault, so, I'm videoing as well and trying to be mildly amusing. Yeah, so I remember this now. Okay, what an idiot. Yeah, no, yeah, I'm going to make you look real bad in this video. There we go, we're going round to our left. I think, oh no, we're not going round to our left. That's the railway track. Yeah, okay, here's the left. So stay with me. Oh, are you? Sorry, I didn't hear you, man. Sorry, bud. Dopey. Yeah, I didn't hear you, bud, sorry. Okay, there's a lot going on at the front here with navigation and the stuff. Oop. Listen, I'm recording as well, so I was trying to tilt my head to the left. But he was on my side of the road as well. Jacobs! Your boy gets around. Wow. River's still down there. And this is our view. Beautiful. Wow, but down there is, oh, I don't know. Can you see on your map what that river is called? Some nice little twisties, yeah? I got you in front now with the view. Left. Or straight on at the moment. Straight on. I think so. We're turning the next left anyway. Left now. Left. Not left, I did say left. Mr. Gee. No, mate, you're a legend. No. Yes. No. Yes. I got that causeway on. Oh, that's a dilapidated house. Donkeys. Oh, I love donkeys. Oh, donkey. Okay. I'm following route notes to the letter, you know. Yeah. Yeah, I got no headlight protection on. Be careful. Indicators on. This is the Gloucester River. It is probably still the Gloucester River, I should imagine. Yeah. Very nice. Teary Bridge. How you going, guys? Where have you come from? Wingham. And where you heading? Cool. All right, well, enjoy. Beautiful. Yeah. You don't want to fall off it, do you? Yeah, and fucking cold. Tree, if you can hear me. Just a nice view down the valley. Probably go in front of me as I'm navigating. Meters at the moment. We're in Tapen Tops National Park. These roads are easy roads. Oxley Highway, 41 kilometres this way.
Is that the
road you
want to go?
No. We.
That's the
lot. We're going that way. Mount George is back. Mount George is back that way. So that's what that's telling us. What road?
There's a big road to the left.
Well, we might have to turn here. Yeah, mine's going in a bend. Yeah, it's quite nice, yeah? It's quite nice. Oh no, okay, there we go. So this is Dingo Top's rest area. Back. I'm going to use the convenience. Elands and Blue Knob Road, Ellenborough Falls. Okay, let's get going. So the turn-off we've got to talk about is the Jeep Trail. And then we'll... No, it's just... when we get to the bottom of that, where the miner's hut is, that's Grassy Ridge Road that takes us up to the Oxley, but it could be too gnarly for us to get up. Yep. It's not... the Jeep Trail going down to it is not too bad. But if it gets gnarly, we just turn back around. I'm not going to take the risk, and I'm not feeling 100%, so, but we'll get to see the battery stamper down there, so that'd be interesting. We should go and have a look at that, even if we don't get out of it, you know. 4:30 or 5:00, it's going to be dark up here. Oh, I just got a big pile of flies in my face. Yeah. No, it's coming out the other side, mate. It's all on the map, and it's all part of getting to the Oxley. So this is the gnarliest track we've done all day. And I'm videoing this now. It's not hard getting back up, so. Yeah, I'm good. Just following directly behind you. It's good that you're leading, actually. It takes a bit of thought away from me, so I can just relax a bit. Should imagine I'd be fine tomorrow. Yeah, you're going to the left. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah, I've got one too. A big one. But it's quite lightweight. Yeah, I've got one. Yep. Never tried it. No, not with me. Yeah. Nice spot. Yeah. Nice spot there. Good swimming hole. This is down the causeway. This is why it's obviously called the causeway. Look at that to the left. Beautiful. Yeah. All right. Keep on going. Up we go. I got a funny feeling we had to go left there. Yeah, we had to go left there, Alistair. Yeah. Yeah, hold on. Yeah, well, this road does get onto it, but it looks like a bit of a gnarly track at the end of it. Yeah, this bike's a bit heavy. Yeah. Yeah, maximum flat. Yep, this doesn't look good. It's all right, it looks a bit better up ahead, so let me just so I'm still recording. Tree. Yeah. Go under. Come back. I got it. Yeah. And I've got to get a, it's quite slippery down here, so we just had to turn around. So we're going to try and push start at Alistair's bike. I couldn't get the kickstand up. Yeah. Society, you're crazy. It's gonna fucking kill me. Sorry? Oh, you clutch it, I'll push. Yeah, I can't drive your ride your bike. Should we push it up to the hill? Well, we'll push it up to the downhill bit. Well, didn't we come uphill? A little bit? Didn't we come uphill at the first part? I think we did. Yeah, let's just push it around the corner and see what we can see. Now you're gonna need a lot of speed. I'll try that. Fuck. Sorry. Let me get my breath. I've got it. Say when you're ready. Try it. I can't run any faster.
I'm starting to get concerned now. I'm feeling pretty ordinary. I've already taken my jacket off because I'm just running hot and cold. And I can't seem to push Alistair's bike because I don't have the energy. So it's looking pretty hard to start at the moment. So I'm hoping that the battery pack will start the bike. Otherwise, we're in a lot of trouble.
We can't clutch Alistair's bike, and we can't get through that way, so we're going to have to take all his bags off, I think, and use the battery pack. Got to watch out for logs. There goes Alistair's helmet into my back. So obviously had a couple of goes here. No go, obviously. Right. Can't put my leg over because I had to put your helmet on. Yes. We're sort of trying to get our way out now, but this is not the planned route, obviously. So, hopefully we'll get to somewhere where there's a sign, as the thread is not giving me any names of any roads, which is ridiculous. So, it's 3:29. Dark in an hour and a half. We're not that far away from the Oxley. 20-30 k's in a straight line. At a guess. Well, we're still trying to find a way out. Look. Drop the bike, Andrew. So we're going to try and go up that road there, I think. Bit of a maze now. At 3:48 and still trying to get out, it's not the ideal situation, but this is why we brought our tents, just in case. From a map it's very hard to tell if this tree's down from a map. And Alistair's bike is running out of electricity. that one there. Mobile phone? No. No, there it is there. That's what we got to get to. So straight up here, bear left, turn right, then we go up there. Get up to there. Still stuck in you. 353. Exciting. Ooh, look at that. Nice. Going up, we going down. Traveled on this, maybe not this far down, but this takes us to the Oxley Highway, and I've seen guys on videos doing this track, so I think it should be clear. So this gets us onto the Oxley, which is good. Hopefully crisis averted. Unless there's a big tree somewhere. Get out of here before it gets dark. The Garmin is very hard to read. It doesn't allow you to tap on that area and tells you what road you're on. So you can't pinpoint where you are. It's either me not knowing how to use this thing properly, or it's just crap. But I think we'll get out. We won't have to. We won't have to, we won't have to camp tonight, I hope. Still gotta be careful, there's a couple of tricky sections. But we've been going quite medium pace slowed all day today, so. A little gnarly, but nothing that the KTM can't handle. Alistair's still behind me. I can see the Oxley just up there. Don't want to have a slip over or a little fall now. We're very close. Sure? Paddocks. Oxley's just up here. I think we're out. I'll get it. Yeah. Doesn't say don't go in. Yeah. The road didn't correspond with the map, which is nothing unusual. So I didn't know which way to go there for a sec. But we're on the right track again. We're going through private property, but there's no lock gates, so. I need some water in me now. Dropping down. Oxley's down there somewhere. I want to go over the edge. Or slip on horse shit or cow shit. Cow shit. Where's Alistair? Come on, mate. Bonnie Brook, and it looks quite deep that side, so I might go this side. Yep. Alistair's gone first. Do you want to check it first? It looks fairly shallow there. Yeah. Straight through.
On the right road, we're not going up to the end of the dead end.
So do I. Made it. What a bitch of a navigation that was. Left, right, left, right, left, right.
All you knew was one name of the road on that map to know exactly where you were. How far are we now? There's no bother. So now I kept thinking, you know, we're going east when I know we should be heading west.
I need a drink, but that's okay. We're not that far. Yeah, it's in my jacket. Okay, sit rep. It is Sunday, the 28th of May. It is a beautiful day. We are on the Oxley Highway. Alistair's somewhere behind me. And we are actually heading home. A bit disappointing. Alistair's bike yesterday ran out of electricity. And in the middle of nowhere. We couldn't go on the trail that we wanted to, so it was quite a task to navigate our way out at the time that it was, you know, coming close to dark, 4 o'clock in the afternoon, and we were still a long way away from this highway, the Oxley Highway. We tried to start Alistair's bike up this morning, just wouldn't start, so we had to make a decision whether we wanted to go into the bush, into a more wilderness area, go towards the town of Kookaburra, or go home, call it quits. I'm not feeling very well. I think I could have got there today, but I definitely couldn't have pushed Alistair's bike too far. It sort of buggered me yesterday. So we've decided to go home, which is, I think we're both disappointed. It was a beautiful ride yesterday, we really enjoyed it. And we've got to come back now, probably sooner rather than later. because it is such a beautiful ride. And we got to know a little bit more about the Sells River region, Dolls River region, and the north of Gloucester. It was an excellent ride. So, heading back home now, 3 hours, we'll be home.